Welcome back to PaperPen Biology. Today's content is on Darkfield microscopy as one of types of light microscope. In the latest video, we learned about resolution and magnification of microscope. If you haven't watched it yet, please do. Before jumping into the main content, let me introduce you with this YouTube channel, diettoms. It has cool videos on DIC microscopy and passionate microscopy related techniques. It will be surely beneficial for you. PaperPen Biology got the opportunity to share screen with diettoms today to make this tutorial more effective. So stay with us till the end of the video. Do explore his channel and make sure to subscribe. So let's learn. First, we need to understand the basic fact about field of view of a microscope. In simple term, it is the area you see under the microscope for a particular magnification. So this diameter of the circle that you see is the field of view. Now it is blank as there is no target specimen, and with a target specimen, usually we see this plate like this, right? This white bright background image is the production of bright field microscope, where light is aimed towards a condenser and most of the light from the condenser through the specimen and through an objective lens and finally to the eye through a second magnifying lens, that is eyepiece. Now the question may arise, then why do you need the alternative technique other than this? There are some limitations, such as it includes low contrast for weakly absorbing samples and low resolution due to blurry appearance of out of focus material. To solve these problems, dark field microscopy has been introduced. As I already mentioned, it is a technique for improving the contrast of unstained transparent specimens, such as living cell or small organisms, or study samples with high refractive index like crystals, minerals. So how does it achieve this? The condensing system for dark field illumination utilizes a central circular disc stop, an opaque disc that prevents direct condenser rays from entering the objective lens. Only those rays that have been suitably scattered by the object enters the objective lens to generate the final image. Let's look into diettoms' work with dark field microscope. As you see the sample as bright object against a dark background, making it easier to see the details and structure. There are three types of condenser, such as Abbe condenser, cardioids condenser, paraboloid condenser for dark field microscope. We need to ensure that the numerical aperture of condenser is greater than that of the highest power objective we will employ. Dark field microscopes needs extremely bright light source. There are some challenges though of using dark field, such as insufficient illumination renders the specimen visible but extremely dim. Overexposure of light might affect some samples. So there are dark area in the center of the field of view, but peripheral objects are well lit. If the sample is thick, background is unevenly lighted with a gray cast. Overall, dark field microscopy is a valuable tool for researchers looking to study samples that are transparent, have low contrast, or are difficult to observe with other techniques. This is it for today. I'll be back soon with another exciting topic. Comment if you have any queries regarding today's class. Subscribe for more such videos and give a thumbs up if our efforts are fruitful to you. Thank you for your patience.